Hello students, myself Shivli Chakravarti, assistant professor, department of IT, Asansol Engineering College. This is our computer organization class and this is class 15. In the last class, we learnt about Booth's multiplication method. Booth's algorithm was the procedure for multiplying binary integer in signed 2's complement representation. We have seen that how the string of zeros and the long string of 1's are created. So string of zeros are only required, to shift the bit. Instead of doing several time addition, only shift operation was enough. Whereas when there is a string of 1, the multiplier, string of 1's in the multiplier from b to 8 to the power k to 2 to the power m is treated as 2 to the power k plus 1 minus 2 to the power m that we have solved in our last class, and we have seen that it's an efficient multiplication method. In this class, we'll be discussing about the division method. For binary numbers, there are two division methods. One is restoring division method, another is non-restoring division method. In this class, we will be discussing about restoring division operation. The division operation that we have learned in our childhood, like for decimal number system, as we have done, the same thing applied for the binary number system too. Let us suppose the number 197 is getting divided by 10. So what in the binary division method, what we have seen that whenever we are doing, suppose we have to divide 113 by 9. Let us suppose this situation. So what we did, if we want to divide it by 9, we used to choose greater than 9, that is 2 bit, that is 11. And then what we did, 9 ones are 9, and then we used to subtract, and thereby we get the remainder. Then again there will be the next iteration. The same process follows here also for binary number system. Well, what we have, so whenever we are dividing by 10, this is the binary of 10, that is 1010, and this is the binary of the dividend, 197. So here, so we can see that when we divide it by here, we have 10 is 1010, it's a 4-bit data. So here also we consider first 4-bit data. Then what we need to check? We need to check whether this is greater or lesser. So in case of binary number system, it's not possible every time some parts of the bit will be checking greater or lesser. Rather, this tape describes that it will consider that number of bit, and then it will subtract from the dividend. The divisor will be subtracted. So what we need to do, the divisor will be subtracted from the first 4-bit. Then after subtraction, we got the result. What is the result? The result is 010, because 001, we take borrow 1, so we got 1. So then 0. So here also one more 0 from 1 minus 1, so we got another 0. But that 0 is discarded, the leftmost bit. So here we got 3-bit. That 3-bit is not enough. So we need to drop the next bit that can be dropped. So now we have found 4-bit. Again, what we are doing, see why we have considered this subtraction. We will consider this subtraction after subtracting. If we found that the number is positive, that means that divisor is lesser than those dividend bit what we have chosen for the subtraction process. So that subtraction can be accepted as the subtracted result is positive. Rather, if it would be negative, we would have not considered this. So we need to get back to this position. What we have not done during manual division operation. In manual division operation, we will verify. We will manually verify, is this greater than this? Okay, now then I can do. So that process is followed here. The manual operation. What we did, see here, after subtraction we found positive result, no problem. Next, after dropping one number, then also the final bit is 0. The most significant bit is, the highest bit is 0. But here the fourth bit is 1. That bit is 0, but here this bit is 1. So that means this number is greater than that. So it will not work if I take 1 in the quotient bit. Rather, what I need to do? I need to put my quotient bit as 0. So here comes again 0. Then what we need to do? Again, we have subtracted. Obviously, after subtraction, I got 1, 0, 0. Then what we need to do? We need to drop that 1. Now what we have? We have 1, 0, 0, 1. See, manually I can see this number is lesser. It won't work. So still what we can do? I have used 1, 0 once again. So 1, 0, 1, 0 into 0. So what we have got? Again 0. After subtraction, we got 1, 0, 0, 1. So 1, 0, 0, 1 is again the number of bit that we are having. But here, that 0 we need to drop as the number is lesser. Because the same loop will be repeated otherwise. So we have dropped this 0. Now this number becomes greater than that. So what I can do? Now we can use a 1 in the quotient bit. Now we have used that 1, 0, 1, 0. After subtraction, what we got? After subtraction, we got this 1, 000. So next, what we need to do? Again, we need to drop that 1. So now it will go 1, 0, 1, 0. Again, I can take 1 as the quotient bit. So 1, 0, 1, 0. After subtraction, we got 0, 1, 1, 1. So no more bit are there that has not been covered. So we can conclude here that the quotient is what? 1, 0, 0, 1, 1 means 16 plus 3, that is 19. So we found our quotient to be 19. We found our remainder to be 7. So 19 tens are 190 plus 7, that is 197. So this is the binary division, like the decimal division, that we have to use. That computer will do this division using some algorithm. The first algorithm that I am explaining is the restoring division algorithm. In this case, what we have done? See, check here, we are having the dividend bit. Let us change the color so that I can, let us change the color to blue. Okay. So what we have done? We have first considered the first 4 bit of dividend, and the divisor is subtracted from the dividend. In the next round, what we did? This is the actually subtracted result. Then the divisor got right shifted 1 bit before subtraction. The same thing. Follow here. Here also we were having this situation. What we did? The divisor got right shifted 1 bit before subtraction. So each time before doing subtraction, the divisor is getting right shifted. This is, instead of applying the process in this way, it would be better that if we apply that, we, instead of right shifting the divisor data, the dividend bit is left shifted 1 bit before each subtraction. So before each round, the whole dividend bit will be left shifted. The resultant is almost same. You see, we were having the dividend bit like this, 1100. So after this round, what do you have found? So the whole data is 1100 0101. So after subtraction, from this we are subtracting 1010. So after subtraction, what we got? The actually the whole subtracted result is, the whole subtracted result is 0, then again 0, then again we do have 1001, then 0, this 4 bit, and the remaining bits are 0101. Now from whom will be subtracted? Next, again we will be subtracted the divisor data, but it will start from here. So what we have did? Divisor data got 1 bit right shifted. The same thing I can say, that dividend got 1 bit left shifted before doing the subtraction. If we follow this step, that before each round the dividend get right shifted, so the register where I have stored the dividend, there we will have a vacant bit at the rightmost position. And in that vacant bit, we will be storing each round the quotient bit that we are getting. This is the formula to apply the algorithm. So this is the hardware architecture to implement the restoring division method. The M register that is used to store the divisor. So we are writing here the ZOR data is stored in M register. The dividend is used the stored in Q register. So the dividend is stored in Q register. The accumulator register or A register that is used to store the result. The result data is stored in the accumulator register. Here we are having an extra flip-flop so that after left shifting the data can be moved this. So A register is initially will be assigned with zero. How many bit? That many bit we are having in the divisor. If the divisor is 4 bit, then the A register will be assigned with 4 bit. Q register will be assigned with dividend bit. So if my dividend is of 5 bit, that means 5 bit I need to traverse. So I have to check whether all 5 bit has been traversed or not. So my iteration will continue 5 times. So depending on the dividend bit, my M register, my sequence counter register will be set, or my size register will be set. M register, depending on the M register number of bit, my accumulator will be assigned with that many number of zero. So here it comes to the actual algorithm. It's been explained with the flowchart. So we start. So we have stored our dividend in Q register. We have already explained. We have stored my divisor data in M register. Accumulator register is assigned with zero. SC counter, that is size counter, is assigned, initialized with the value N. Next, we follow this shift left operation. First step that we follow is the left shift operation. Initially, I told that if we do have our AQ pair data, where in the A register, I have initialized it with all zero, where in the Q register, I do have my dividend bit. So the first step will be, we will do a left shift operation. That is the very first step. So what is the result of left shift? The leftmost bit will be discarded. The second left bit will occupy leftmost bit. And in this way, the first bit, the 0th bit of the Q will appear in the 1th bit. So what is the result? The result is that the 0th bit creates a vacant position. After this left shift operation, we will subtract the divisor from A. We will do the subtraction. So the second step of the restoring division method is to subtract M from A. After subtraction, we might have got some result. The third step is to check the sign of the result, whether the result is positive or the result is negative, that we need to check. So the third step is to check the sign of the result. If the sign is positive, that means that subtraction is well accepted. If the result is negative, that subtraction could not be accepted. So if the result is positive, what we do? We found the N minus bit as 0. That means the result is positive. So if A N minus 1 is 0, the result is positive. So in that case, we are setting Q0 bit to be 1. That means the first quotient bit we got as 1. Instead, if we found my result, if we found my result as negative, if we found my result as negative, I might change the color. So if we found my result as negative, what we need to do? We cannot consider this subtraction. We have to restore back to the original data. We cannot accept this subtraction anymore. So what do we do? We set our Q0 bit to be 0. And what we did A is equal to A minus M. We will once again do A is equal to A plus M. That means we are following the restoration process. After this restoration process, we have covered all three steps in a single iteration. One iteration is complete. Then what we will check? We will check our SC counter or our size variable. The size variable is set as S minus 1 or SC minus 1. And thereby, we will check, has size reached to 0? If it has been reached to zero, that means we don't need to consider anymore. We got our final result. The quotient data is set in Q and the remainder data is set in A that we will show with by solving one example. But if it is not equal to zero, that means iteration is not complete. SC first initialized with 5. In the next round, SC will be reinitialized with 4. In the next round, SC will be reinitialized with 3. In the next round, SC will be reinitialized with 2. So in this way, the process will continue. So here, once again, the iteration start. Once again, the left shift. Again, A is equal to A minus M. Again, check A n minus 1, 0 or 1. Again, we will do set Q 0 is equal to. In this way, all the step will be followed. So better we explain this algorithm with one example. So let us, we are dividing 7 by 3. So 7 is our dividend. Dividend will be stored in Q register. So I need to change the color so that it is better visible here. So we have set our Q variable with 7. And our accumulator register is initialized with 0, 3 bit. Why? Because our M is 3. Where is our M? M is 3. The binary of plus 3 is 0, 1, 1. So our M is, as our M is 3. So 3 bit are there. For plus 3, we took 3 bit. So accumulator register is enough to be initialized with 3 zeros. We are solving the process in this way. And how many bit we are having in our Q variable? In our Q register, the number of variable is 4. So for that reason, we have initialized our size variable by 4. So at the very beginning, we are having this AQ pair data. So what is our first step of our algorithm? Shift left AQ pair. So our first step is shift left AQ pair. So we start with shift left. So what we have done? This 0 bit left shifted. So this 0 appears here. This 0 appears here. This 0 appears here. This 1 appears here. In this way, this 1 appears here. So here what happens? We got a vacant position. We found one vacant position. So in this vacant position, what will be the result? That we come later. So first what we need to do? After shift left operation, do we need to check anything? No. We need to do A is equal to A minus M. So we'll be doing what? A is equal to A minus M. What is minus M? First we do the calculation of minus M. That is 1's complement of M is 100 plus 1. So 101. So my minus M is equal to 101. So we want to do A is equal to A minus M. That is, that means A plus minus M. Minus M is 101. So after this A minus M, we finally got the result, that is 101. So after doing this A is equal to A minus 1, what is the next step? So after A is equal to A minus M, next step is, what is the sign of the data A? Is it positive or negative? So we check the sign of A. Is it positive or negative? The data is positive or negative? The data is negative. So A n minus 1 is negative. Can we consider this subtraction? No. This subtraction cannot be accepted. So what we have to do? We have to get back to the earlier status. That means we have to restore. So restore means once again we do plus M. So that means we get back to the earlier position. What is our earlier position? Our earlier position was 3 zeros. So we come again with 3 zero. Why? Because we have done the restoration process. So since we are restoring, what will be the data that will be filled with Q0 position? It is filled with 1, 0. So that is our restoration process. And then what we did? SC is equal to SC minus 1. So 4 minus 1, we get back 3 now. Then what we have to do? Once again, we have to check. So we have already, what we have done? So follow the algorithm. After checking, we have set Q0 to be 0. We have restoration. We have done size minus 1. So next is we need to check the size. What is the value of size? Is it 0? No. That means again the iteration. So again left shift. Left shift means this 0 vanished. this zero appears here. In this way, this zero appears here. This one appears there. So we have found one vacant position again in the Q0 bit. Then what is the second step? The second step is A is equal to A minus N. That is we are doing. So after addition, what we found? 110. Is this positive or negative? Once again, we got the negative data. So once again, we need to restore. We have to set the Q0 bit to be zero. We have to decrement that SC variable by one. So we got two. And finally, we have got this data 001 1100 here 2. Has size reached to zero? No. So once again, the same repetition. So now what we need to do? We need to again do the left shift operation. So zero is left shifted there. This zero appears here. This one appears here. This one appears here. This zero appears here. Here we have got one vacant position. So now again, what is the second step? A is equal to A minus M. What is minus M? 101. So we do plus 101. So 110 110 110. Leftmost bit 1 cannot be stored. So what we have found? We found the result 000. Is it positive or negative? Leftmost bit is 0. So the data is positive. So now is the time that we can set our Q0 bit to be 1. That we have done over here. That data has been set to 1. So that data has been set to 1. Now, SC counter has been decremented by 1. Has it reached to 0? No. So one more round. SC shift left AQ pair. So that 0 vanishes. That 0 appears here. That 1 appears here. That 1 comes here. Here we got a vacant position. In this vacant position, what will be the data? That we are coming later. So next, the second step is equal to A minus M. So what do we mean by A is equal to A minus M? What is minus M? Minus M is 101. So 101. So 110 11. So we got 110. Again, what is the resultant data? Is it positive or negative? It's a negative data. Since it is negative data, we have to restore, we have to get back what we were. So we were in 001, so we got 001 after restoration process, and the Q0 bit will be set to 0. So now my SC counter is been decremented to 0. So has we reached to 0? Yes, we have reached to 0. What is our final result? Our final result, let us consider some different color. Our final result is our A accumulator register. It's not changed. I want to change the color. So our final result is our, what happened? This red color, okay. So this is our final result, that is our 001 is the accumulator register with remainder, and the Q register with the quotient value. So 0010 means in decimal 2. 001 means in decimal 1. What was the divisor? 3. It was 3. So 3, 2 is 6 plus 1 equal to 7. So right, a division operation is absolutely right. So in this way, we follow the restoring division method. The thing is that what we did, instead of right shifting the divisor data, that thing we need to remember, in each turn, the first step is we are left shifting the AQ pair. That is the first step. What is the second step? Second step is we have subtracted the divisor bit from this A, that is A is equal to A minus M. Then what we did, we checked the resultant data whether it is positive or negative. If the resultant data is positive, we have accepted the subtraction by setting Q0B to be 1. If the data resultant data is negative, we cannot accept this subtraction process and we reject this by setting Q0B to be 0 and restoring back the register content of A. And the iteration follows up to the number of bit present in the dividend odd. Rather, in a way, we can say that until all the bit of the dividend is being traversed, the process continues. So in this way, you have to solve one more example. So this is one assignment. You do division by, you do divide 11 by 4, and thereby you follow the steps and you will come to the actual result, and in this way you can verify. So for now, thank you. In the next class, we will be solving the non-restoring division method. Thank you all.